Okay. Three out, three middle, three in.
Okay.
Remember to finish that attack through that ball. Oh, nice shot.
I thought it was going to hit the tee. Hit run. That's where I want to see you let go of the bat. After your fucking big ass arms can't finish around your body. Yeah, like that. If you're letting go of the bat like that,
There's
undeniably no fucking hip lock. No restriction whatsoever. So if that bat is let go out here, that's everything that you fucking got on there.
Okay. I'll try that. Scared me. I thought that was a baseball. I was like, "Woo! Thank goodness."
Maybe I need some LED visual cues or so. That one you were for.
Yeah.
So the three things that you concentrate. First and foremost, that's why we'll have them pitch over the ball just so you can get the feel. Is the first and foremost swing through that fucking second ball.
Yeah.
Second, stay back. And third, hold on to that bat as long as you can. Outside pitch, you hit the fucking ball.
Yeah, I know.
That's
the one.
What we wanted. We could put the sand balls on there, the weighted balls. They're easy. I have orange anxiety because of where I work.
Oh, yeah. It
fucking gives me PTSD.
Constructed orange.
Yeah. your back. Zone. That essentially what you're doing is you're keeping your fucking bat in the fucking zone.
Zone as long as possible. Yep.
For you, you don't try to yank it.
Yeah.
Good.
That's all the shit on.
Yeah, they are.
That was cool.
That was fucking cool. You got that on video.
I know. That was fucking cool. I don't know if the ball hit into my barrel. I was going to say I hit it the whole way.
You're watching the ball the whole fucking way.
I was surprised, though. I will say that. I was like, oh, fuck, I got it.
Good.
Feel that from here, being able to let go.
Yep. If you think, a lot of the times, if you think about this palm staying flat at contact and a little bit after, it's hard to think of when to let it go. But if you hold that palm down after contact, then most of the time it's going to do exactly what you want to do it. Try to use that as a swing thought one time. Ball. Oh, it's actually hard to do. You haven't hit the tee once, you've hit the ball.
Yeah.
I can tell you're a pitcher.
Yeah.
Maybe when you get up there, start using that. That visual cue. Hit the whiffle ball.
Or do some bullpen like that.
Yeah. Money. Get some. So what did you do on that one?
Came forward and up a little bit.
Came up, yep. More than likely you came up because you came forward. Stay back and attack. We kept numbers on your rotation speed.
Yeah.
I'd like to see where it was at. Baseballs in front of you.
Oh, I need to stride.
Yep. Nope. Do it again. Slice it. Yes. That should feel better.
Yeah.
Good. One more round. Good. Attaboy. It's one of the best gadgets that Evan brought it over. It's one of the best gadgets I've seen for fucking...
The racquetball racket?
Yep, yep. Everybody that fucking swings at a tennis ball, I have yet to see somebody not look at the ball while it hits a fucking racket.
Yeah.
And you feel that slice movement. That's what the swing thought that I like about it the most, is you feel that rear wrist. It doesn't unhinge, it doesn't whatever, it's just there. And all you're rotating is letting your hands fall into the fucking zone. If you try to do too much with the wrist, you're going to get bent like that, you're going to roll over all that fucking shit. Think of the racket. Think of the racket. Hey, I'm just glad you're fucking swinging all the way through, man. On those low pitches, obviously you're going to let them go.
Yeah.
In games and everything. On those low pitches, it's important to stay back because you want to get forward to cut off the angle when you see it dropping. Stay back. It came up on you. Toe taps just to get in the groove, feel that back leg, feel that rear side. Oh. All right, two more.
Just got that ball down.
Yeah. It's fucking locked. Yeah, finish on that one.
Okay.
Get some wiffles.
Yeah.